whatever experiments were going on here are not running loose.
Just got another report from one of the growth farms.
Huh. Hello! Welcome to Hamadi Station. I do hope you're here about the research assistant opening. We haven't had many promising applicants.
By which he means we haven't had any applicants.
Well, yes. Thank you for the painful reminder. Oh, love of my life. I'm Azad Dubas. My wife, Shireen, and I are scientists. We've been quite busy lately and are greatly in need of some help. We put out a call for a research assistant, but with recent events, we haven't had much luck.
By which he means we haven't had any luck.
This could become tiresome quickly.
So, are you interested in a little field work? Ah, so you've some experience then. The Great Serpent has truly blessed us. My wife and I have been studying a recent and somewhat troubling phenomenon. You see, the local wildlife has been dying, and we're not sure why. The remains show no signs of external injury or trauma, so we can rule out most of the usual causes.
Fighting for dominance or territory, predators, hunters looking for sport, those sorts of things.
We began to see this phenomenon just after the accident in Dazra. We're convinced these events are linked, but the exact nature of the connection remains a mystery. An accurate assertion. This is where you come in. I need you to search for corpses of local wildlife and collect tissue samples. I'll give you a biosample collector that will extract and store the samples safely. Try to collect samples from different kinds of creatures. We want to cast a wide net. Return here when you've got them, and we'll begin the analysis.
The prospect of tearing rotten flesh from animal corpses is not what I would call appetizing.
Off you go, then, and no dragging your feet. You're on the clock as of now.
have anything of value?
Thank you.
amount to something. Remote lab facilities are sometimes set up to engage in activities that are dangerous, illegal, or bold.
Welcome back. Did you have any difficulty obtaining those tissue samples? I'm glad to hear it, because there's more work to do. Your arrival is well-timed. Some interesting new information has come to light. I'll take those tissue samples, and here's your payment. Shireen, dear, would you tell our dauntless research assistant about the latest news?
With pleasure. I hope you enjoyed your little jaunt into the field, because I'll be sending you right back out there. Some of the local farmers and growth herders have reported seeing unusual plant growth in the area. What's more, none of this unusual growth was seen before the Dazra incident. It's increasingly clear the event affected the ecosystem in some way, but the details elude us. My thinking exactly. You really are cut out for this kind of work. Based on our information, these unusual new strains aren't limited to a specific area. As such, we want to examine samples that come from several different locations. In short, The more data you can provide, the better.
Observe, analyze, hypothesize, and prove. These are the tenets of the scientific method. Without them, we are just fumbling in the dark.
Yes, thank you, dear. You'll have to forgive my husband. He's never fully recovered from his days as a teacher. Agreed. I've always felt sorry for those who can't find work they truly love. The days must feel like sheer drudgery. We'll get to work studying the animal tissue. Now go forth and travel safely.
There's no greater endeavor than the pursuit of knowledge. Now go forth and pursue.
is a satisfying moment. Return to your ship. Should exercise caution. Things in here may not react well to bullets.
roving research assistant returns.
I know we've asked you to travel far and wide. Hopefully it wasn't too much trouble. Good. It seems that things have been going smoothly so far. Perhaps it's a sign that the Great Serpent favors our work. Here's the payment for those plant samples. I have good news. We've got a strong working theory about what's killing the local wildlife. The tissue samples you collected point to poisoning as the likely cause of death. I'm afraid so. Needless to say, the urgency of our work has increased somewhat. The evidence suggests that some force is acting on the ecosystem, changing it somehow. We don't yet have the complete picture, but there is one tool left to us. Would you care to explain, my dear?
With pleasure. To aid in our monitoring of local conditions, we designed a multifunction sensor suite. The device records data for weather, atmospheric pressure, radiation,
airborne particulates, seismic disturbances, gravitic fluctuations.
Could we please move on?
Yes, of course. We placed several of these sensors throughout the area. Each device can upload its data to a slate for comparison and analysis. It's just a collection of devices fused together and running on a single power source. It's more a feat of improvisation than engineering, really. Here, take this. Transfer the data from each of the sensors and then bring the slate back to me. In the meantime, we'll see what we can learn about these unusual plant specimens. We'll solve this riddle yet. Welcome back. Time to see if our sensors can peel back another layer of the mystery. Did you notice anything unusual in the environmental data? Not to worry. Your task was to collect the data, not interpret it. I was just asking out of curiosity, really. Now, let's have a look, shall we? Seems mundane enough. Oh, now wait just a moment. As I suspected, the sensors simultaneously recorded a single event that produced very unusual impacts. This is our best glimpse yet into the Dazra accident and how it affected the surrounding environs. How interesting! The chronometer seemed to have gone haywire in all four of the devices. Even gravity itself seems to have been briefly altered. Remarkable! A rudimentary summation, perhaps, but not without merit. Your payment as promised. Now, I'm sure you're wondering what we've learned from the plant tissue samples you brought back. I thought you might say that. So, it seems that a certain local species of flora has suddenly become extremely toxic. These biochemical changes occurred with incredible speed. Notably, the first sightings of these toxic variants coincide with the incident in Dazra. I'm just not sure how the strange effects of the vortex could cause plants to mutate so rapidly.
By triggering a defensive response. Countless species of fauna have evolved to develop protective mechanisms. Poisonous toxins are among the most common such adaptations.
That's true, but those adaptations evolved over generations across long spans of time. These seem to have appeared in a matter of mere days. That shouldn't be possible.
And yet, the sensors documented fluctuations in the very fabric of space and time. Who's to say what's impossible when the fundamental laws that govern our reality are altered? If all else fails, then you might be right. Hopefully we can find a more benign solution.
Shireen, do you remember that experimental compound you were developing?
The one designed to alter plant biochemistry? Interesting thought. I'd been theorizing about ways to create edible strains of local flora. It's possible I could alter the formula to neutralize the toxins in the affected species.
There is, however, a not insignificant complication.
I knew you were going to say that.
The experimental compound is locked away in cold storage at the botanical facility. I was growing strains of fungus and mushroom there for medicinal use. But we were attacked. A group of pirates called the Crimson Fleet took over the place, forcing us to leave. Pirates! Here, on Varunkai! I could scarcely believe it. That might not be as helpful as you expect. House Kadik claims the pirates are a splinter faction with their own agenda. It's likely they'll be hostile to anyone outside their country. Go with the Serpent's blessing. We'll be waiting for you here.
Lost it.
The Crimson Fleet are all too willing to prey on the weak or defenseless. Perhaps we will show them what it means to put up a fight. Take what you must. The rest for the scavengers.
Give up already.
Enough for this.
are. I cannot wait for you.
Thank you.
Extra ammunition is always welcome if they have any. To lighten your load. One is less likely to survive an ambush when one is weighed down with whatever all that is. I would move the stars for you. I am always willing to carry an extra weapon. Or two. Or three. You will think of me, I hope. Thank you. Profit is never necessarily the aim, but if there is something worth taking...
Well, look who's back. And still in one piece, no less. Have you now? Well, bravo then. When Azad first suggested taking on an assistant, I'll admit that I had my doubts. I'm happy to say that you've laid them all to rest. Here you are. Payment as promised. Did you hear that, love? Our courageous research assistant has delivered yet again.
I never had a shred of doubt. Nothing inspires courage and perseverance like the pursuit of knowledge, I always say.
That is quite literally the first time I've ever heard you say that.
Well, I certainly always think it.
Yes, dear. Of course you do. Indeed, we do. Thanks to you, we not only have the answer to our little mystery, but a path to resolving it. Here's a little something extra for a job well done. Best of luck in your future scientific endeavors.
Oh, bless the great serpent for bringing you to us. Your help was invaluable.